So, good morning, everybody. Let's start. It's a couple of minutes after 10, so we don't want to hold you too long. Today we are together with our tool vendor that we have happily invited also for this webinar. So we're together with Jan Voskuil from Ontopharma. Jan will do the first presentation, and then later on we will take over and show you the tool that they developed and we are supporting with the implementation. So Jan, I'm not sure if you are. Are you online?
Can you hear me?
Yes, now yes.
Okay, well, Remco, thank you so much. My name is Jan Voskuil. I am co-founder and a CEO of Taxonomic. Taxonomic is a consultancy aimed at linked data. Linked data is a relatively new technology designed for working with highly complex distributed data. And it offers new solutions to data governance challenges. We've been around for 5 years now. We're 20 people strong. And last year, we founded our spin-off, Ontopharma. Ontopharma's mission is to innovate the way information flows in the pharma domain. And of course, we are using linked data and other semantic technologies to do this. Remco, can I have the next slide, please? Okay, so we are working on a whole suite of products which together constitute a solution. Our flagship application is the extractor, which we will see later today. The extractor can be used in isolation. It stands on its own, but it fits into a larger picture. The larger picture is shown here. Well, it all starts with Vocabulary Connect, which is our platform to manage controlled vocabularies. It is connected to the RMS system of the EMA when it comes online later this year, and it manages all the different controlled vocabularies, both the ones that are needed for IDMP and many beyond. The extractor takes these vocabularies to recognize terms and values in SMPCs. It turns essentially textual documents into data sets. It also can annotate different text fragments. So in the end, you will have structured data and annotated text fragments, and these can be used in a structured authoring tool for new ways of dealing with large amounts of text variants in different languages and in different procedures. So this is the larger picture. We are very much focused on delivering quality, so we also do all kinds of cross checks, and for that we use the text verification tool of Schlafender Hase. Today, however, we will focus on the extractor. We will show you how we can take an SMPC, a textual SMPC, and create an IDMP compliant data set out of that. So that's basically my part of the presentation. So enjoy.
Okay, thanks, Jan, for the explanation. So just to give the full picture, my name is Remco Munich. I'm the Regulatory Information Director of Asphalion. Asphalion, we are an international regulatory and scientific consultancy, offices in Barcelona and Munich. We are now more than 80 people, worldwide experience, more than 15 years supporting our clients, and a lot of clients international. So what do? We give support for regulatory affairs. Just to prove that we are more than just me on the phone. This is a picture of our annual excursion that we do. But we also give support from regulatory scientific strategy, so really helping companies develop their products, supporting with the medical and scientific writing, global submissions, and then I'm responsible for the electronic submissions. So I'm in direct contact with the EMA and the national competent authorities. I'm also part of the ISO IDMP work group. I'm part of the ECDD work group, the CES, the e-application forum, so a lot of groups that I'm involved. For this we are looking for partners and how we can serve our clients. We also support companies with the maintenance, variations, procedures, and also pharmacovigilance. So if you have any question about any drug, biologic, advanced therapy, medicine or product, or medical devices, please contact us. We would be more than happy to help you. So later on the presentation, we'll also explain something about Extido. Extido, we are a consulting partner of Extido. So Extido is a German software provider. They were formed from a German company called IABG. They are supporting more than 35 national competence authorities, including EMA. They have a regulatory information management solution. They have a global partner network, which includes us, operating in more than 60 countries, offices in Europe and US, and also 700 global partners. So today we will show you a demo on how we can extract the data, but once the data is extracted, also to have an ID on where can we put the data and how you can consume it within your organizations. So Extido has different tools. They have publishing, they have product registration, they have planning and tracking, and they have pharmacovigilance, and we're trying to combine all these strengths together into the best service for our clients. So this is an overview of the different tools, which you can read later. This is a few of Extido's clients. So you can see a mix of big pharma, medium-sized pharma. And this is an overview of the authorities that they are working with in direct contact. So a lot of experience. So, but the focus of today is the data extraction. So we will focus on that. Why data extraction? I mean, what we are seeing is that a lot of we in pharmaceutical industry, we generate a large amount of data. But historically, a lot of the data that we are creating, we are storing in documents only. And some specific data elements, for example, the product name and registration number or MA number, MA holder, we are entering in RIM solution, regulatory information management solution, regulatory databases. But we also see that a lot of these RIM solutions were not complete. There was different data between RIM solutions and other solutions that companies have, and we also see a disconnect between different departments. Let's say a product name doesn't exist in one company in one location and exists multiple times. So also with the XEVMPD implementation, we have seen that a lot of companies are copy-pasting data from their SPCs into their RIM solution, into Excel. And I think Excel is still the most used RIM solution out there. But it also, XEVMPD made us realize, look, we as industry need to capture more data and less, start working less with documents. ISO IDMP will also be implemented. ISO IDMP will require a lot more data gathering, a lot more processing of this data, and we were looking into how we can go from this unstructured data source in structure. So now we see a lot of issues that a lot of data currently is stored in different places in different ways, which leads to duplication, which leads to waste, which leads to room for optimization within your company. And ISO IDMP, it really requires pharmaceutical industries to extract data from documents into structured data elements. So we started to look for tool vendors that can do this. So the idea is, no, we have any kind of unstructured data source, a Word document, a PDF, whatever. We can extract the data with the tool. We can perform mapping. We can perform structured data and establish the single source of truth. So we looked around for different tool vendors and we came across OntoPharma, Taxonic. So, and we were really happy for until now. No, I mean, we're really happy with the collaboration. So what we normally do is we're looking for the best technical solutions for our clients. No, so we did a review of different data extraction tools. So this tool really provides a high accuracy, super good performance. Data is extracted in a matter of seconds. There's an excellent and easy process for data verification. We can edit directly the data into the tool. It's easy to use. my team is using it on a daily basis, but the first time that I had to use it, I intuitively already understood how to work with it. It is IDMP compliant, it can be adapted to any language, it has a very competitive pricing module, it doesn't have a large fee to start working with it, and it's really client-driven development. No, all the we are now collaborating with OntoPharma, and all the tips that we have given within a matter of days, minutes, it has been implemented. So really happy with the support. So what do we see from data extraction? Well, I mean, if we have to extract the data manually and verify the data, no, it takes really a lot of time. I mean, some estimation is 2.5 hours per SPC. Automated data extraction can really be a matter of seconds, and with the tool, it can really assist the user for semi-automatic verification. So it reduces the time to a number of minutes. So instead of spending a lot of hours, you can do really the data extraction and verification in a matter of minutes. So we will now go live into the demo. So I will switch to the web-based. So we have access to a sandbox environment where we can play with the system, etc. So the system is relatively intuitive. What you see on the left-hand side, you see here some folders, so you can create a subfolder yourself. Just before the demo, I created a subfolder called demo. Here on the right, you see product browser, document browser, so we can search for documents, search for products. We can export all documents to a dictionary. That's the idea. We can move all products into a trash, but the first thing that we need to do is, of course, add documents. So I have a folder with some documents, which I will have to open. So let me show you. I have here three documents, three SPCs, one English, one Dutch, one Spanish, and I'm able to drag and drop them into the correct folder, so I can just drag and drop them, and I say submit. As soon as they are submitted, upload is succeeded, so I'm done. I can add more files, I can clear them, I can submit more, but in this case I'm done, and I can go now to the document level, and I can see already in the folder demo, in the meantime that I was explaining, they have already been processed. So even if you have a large number of SPCs, you can see that they have been uploaded, they have been processed, and they have been processed. Once they are processed, they are available in the product browser, and in the product browsers we will see now three products. These are the three SPCs that we uploaded, and if I, for example, want to open the first one, the Dutch SPC, if I make a double click, it opens the SPC as we have the data on the right-hand side. You will see the entire SPC as it is with the text. And on the left-hand side, we see the data that was already extracted automatically. Here on the right-hand side in the source, we can also navigate quickly. If I want to go to the indications, I can go to the indications. No, and I can see the indications. I can read them. If I want to go to the product name with the index, I quickly navigate to the product name. And so, for example, the product name, it says here Asphalina 10 milligram, and I'm Dutch, so I can say it Maagzuur Resistente Capsule Hard. So it's a. And here on the left hand side, we see the same product name, but already with different colors. And there's also a button called Edit. And the system is already even proposing it. It says, look, Asphalina, we see this is not a generic name, no, it's not a name of an active substance, so it must be an invented name. So the system already provides the information, this is an invented name. If you do not want to have it as an invented name, because you say, no, actually this was the flavor, which is not the case in this case, I could select the text and I change it, and you see, it automatically, system will save it already as flavor. Well, obviously this is not correct, so I have to say again, invented name. But it also identifies that 10 milligram is the strength and the pharmaceutical dosage form is the capsule hard. So the system already is able to understand which referentials are used, which is the dosage form, which is the strength, etc. So I can either now save the changes or cancel. And the same is applicable for all these data elements. So all these data elements, the ATC code is extracted directly from the SPC, and the registration number, the data first authorization, the MA holder, the address in Dutch. So what else do we have? We have the indications, we have the route of administration. So all the data that we have identified that we would like to have from this from the SPC is already extracted. The same happens if we go to another SPC. So if we go back, if I go back to the demo folder, if I go to the other SPC, this is a Spanish SPC, and also here the product name is correctly splitted, where we see in this case we have a generic name of S-Omeprazole. So S-Omeprazole, the system already sees it's a scientific name. The company name is Asphalion. The strength is 20 milligrams, and the comprimidos gastroresistentes was defined as the pharmaceutical dose form. So all the companies that did manually the XEVMPD, with this you can really do it automatically. If we had had this at the time of XEVMPD, it would have saved industry a significant amount of time. Now, that's a pity that we are only having this now, but with the advantages that with ISO IDMP, we have to do more coding, we have to extract more data, so it's excellent timing to get your data structured. If we go to the English SPC, I will show you also something more. So for example, the clinical particulars. If I open the clinical particulars, no, it already, for the MEDRA code, it already provides a suggestion for the MEDRA coding. So even if I want to do a MEDRA coding, if I want to add here the MEDRA code, I can quickly drag and drop the MEDRA code and I'm done. And the same is for intended effect and for comorbidities. So I can save the changes and the data will be saved, that from now on we have already here an indication. If you want to have multiple indications, no, because sometimes multiple things, we can also add an indication and we can select the text, add the indication, we can remove the indication. So that's really quick, really easy, really user-friendly. In the settings, when the extracted data, you can also activate and deactivate which data you want to select. If you are not interested in the route of administration because you already have this somewhere in a tool, you can deactivate it. If you're not interested in the indications, you can deactivate it. So it really depends what you want. Okay. So I think the tool really, it already identifies which language is used, which file name are we extracting, what kind of document is it. For now, we only focused on the SPC, but the technology is also there to focus on any kind of documentation. If we go back to the demo folder, there was also here a blue button in front of the product. It says start new export. And if I say start new export, automatically an export is being performed into Excel, where we have both the SPC text. So here I have the entire SPC with the whole text blocks. And on the other hand, I also have still the attributes. So all the data that we managed to get from non-structured data into structured data, attributes, this contains all the information and also the mapping that I did. So also if I had done a MEDRA code here, it would have been here. So this is really nice. Data is being from non-structured data into structured data. Now the only question that we had is, okay, from this moment on, what do we do next? So I'm really happy with the extraction. I mean, just to show you, the data extraction is really in a matter of seconds. So this was a screenshot that we did yesterday. I mean, you see, SNPCs are being queued and processing, but in the same second it's being already processed. So it's only hardly possible to show you how quick it is. Probably if you add some more documents, we will see it. So as explained, it's already data export can be done in Excel, but also in different formats, in CSV files, XML files, and that also shows us how can we process it further. And once we have this export, the question is, where can we put it? So here we talk to Xtido. Xtido has a product database called MPD Manager. MPD Manager is the tool that we use already for our clients. So any client that has externalized their XEVMPD maintenance, XEVMPD will remain valid for the next 4 to 5 years at least. So some companies are facing problems with the fact that no third acknowledgements, EMI is changing the data, how do you track these? And with this tool, we can really help customers, and with our services, we add value to this database. So with MPD Manager, it's a product database, it's XEVMPD compliant. There's a new version coming for MPD Manager for IDMP, and we were talking, okay, how can we use this? So it's a central product data repository where we can enter all the data. We can generate reports, it's XEVMPD compliant, we can submit by gateway directly to EMA, we can track the third acknowledgements, it's GXP compliant, so we can track who changed what, at what time. So the idea is, once we have the data exported from the tool, we can also import it into the MPD manager. So we can then perform regulatory activities, variations, we can have an SMPC view, we can even in future generate a new SMPC document from this tool. So in the tool, we have a button for export all products into the dictionary, and the idea is that then automatically the data as exported from the SPC will be available in the dictionary. So these are some screenshots. You can have a last activity view in MPD Manager, so you can see what were the last products that you worked on. You can also see, okay, what are the products that we imported from the tool, no? So from the extraction tool, and it's already structured the data here, so we can already see immediately what we extracted. The data will then be displayed in some kind of, you know, in a database where we can see, okay, what kind of product name do we have? What is the ATC code, additional monitoring, so all the data elements that we extracted, we can put in this tool. Then in addition, there will be some kind of SMPC view where we have the product name and also not only the data element, not only the text blocks, but also the data elements. So really useful. And then in future, what we really would like to have is also generate an SMPC from this tool. So structured data, the end result is ISO IDMP compliant structured data, which can be edited, processed, reused, and submitted. This is still work in progress. We are also discussing with the authorities of working towards an electronic SMPC and patient information leaflet. I'm also part of the regulatory optimization group. The regulatory optimization group is looking in how can we find ways to optimize our daily work. Just to give you an example, if we now have there's a PRAC decision, from the pharmacovigilance group, there's a decision to include a contraindication in the patient information leaflet. We as industry really take a long time to perform the variation for the agency to review it, final approval, final translation, next printing run that we put the updated patient information leaflet, and easily 1 year, 2 years have passed before a simple contraindication change have been included in the patient information leaflet, which is a little bit strange in this time of era, now that we are living, everybody has mobile phones, data is exchanged quicker, we're tweeting, we have smartphones, so why wouldn't it be possible that if we have a change in contraindication, we just make an electronic update of the patient information leaflet and get this data as to the patient also by notification. You get, as a patient, you get a notification in your mobile phone like, there's now a new contraindication. So this is really work in progress that we want to do. We want to go to an electronic patient information leaflet. We want to work towards an electronic SMPC. In the past, there was a project called PIM. We are not going back to PIM, but at least we need to have some kind of functionality. So I think also companies need to start thinking about how we can do the automatic data extraction to get your data instead of in documents as data. And once it is data, also have it more lean available for further processing. So it's a huge improvement over manual extraction and verification. So I'm very happy with this services, and I'm very excited about this to share this with you, and hopefully there will also be questions. If, by the way, you have any questions, feel free to put them into the question, and then at the end of the presentation, we will go through it. We also wanted to give you a short update of the ISO IDMP status. So 12th and 13th of June, I went to IMA where we had a meeting. Unfortunately, there was a communicated there was a delay in the project. The delay was due to Brexit and the relocation of IMA. I mean, not only to that, but it's obviously it affects the timelines. There's also also the IMA experience with the organization and referential go live. There was some delay with that. No, an organization. Organization and references should be relatively straightforward and easy, but some technical issues were found, and also I think it's something that we need to discuss still with the national competent authorities, IMA and industry. Is are we ready for ISO IDMP? No, I mean we want to change the target operating module. We want to change how we work with authorities. I want to submit data structured from the beginning. The authorities will evaluate it already in structured data, and they will notify us structured. But we still have there an issue that IMA needs to we need to discuss with the national competent authorities what are we going to do with the XE VMPD data and how are we going to validate it. I think also as industry, we need to get prepared, we need to get ready. The tools are, I mean, sometimes I hear about tools that are IDMP compliant. I'm like, IDMP standard is still not finished, so we still have some questions how the tool really works, but it's really something that we need to look into it. And I think industry also needs to look into the mirror and to say, okay, we need to make a step to get IDMP. So good messages from the IMA is the budget for IDMP SPOR has been allocated. It's the only project that's really confirmed to proceed after relocation of IMA. However, it's also clear that the EU implementation guides will not be published in 2018. The original planning was that the EU implementation guide will be published in 2018, and then 1 year later, it would have been mandatory for industry. Now it's clear that the EU implementation guides will not be published in 2018. That's why industry will also not be requested to start submitting the product data in IDMP in 2019. We have already the organization and referential data available, and it went live on 19th of June 2017 for authorities, and from October 2017 industry can use it. I think ISO IDMP will be implemented. From a regulatory optimization perspective, we really need ISO IDMP. We need to be able to use to have a single source of truth, to have an easy identification. I mean, I'm getting tired of putting the product name in the cover letter, application form, ECDD envelope, CES delivery file. We need to have one single source of truth, one single place where we put the product name. And I think ISO IDMP is that way forward. So I think ISO IDMP will be implemented. It will be with be delayed, but it's needed also to realize this optimization, and I think companies should really look at IDMP to see this as an opportunity to align data across your departments and affiliates. And one of these things is, for example, into this data extraction. SMPCs are now in a lot of companies. We're still working with SPCs that are documents, and I think we have to go to a situation that SPCs are really data. So XE VMPD maintenance. If you are a company, you might have to reconsider your change of plans for XE VMPD IDMP compliance. In the past, the idea was that XE VMPD would only be here for 4 years. If we now see that XE VMPD will at least be there till 2020, so that's at least the next couple of 3, 4, 5 years, you might consider to implement already an internal database that it can do XE VMPD. You have to consider what are you doing with the third acknowledgements, the changes that IMA does. You might consider help of a third party. So, for example, Asphalion, we can help you with this. also internal databases, RIM solutions. We are looking for different RIM solutions. Depending on your company, it might also be the different solutions might be have. And I think companies should also consider working with data instead of documents. So also start thinking about an electronic labeling solution, and what we have right now really looks. Okay, so what we see is IDMP is really not a sprint, it's a marathon. It's something that you cannot implement very quickly. It's changing processes, it's changing IT system, it's changing the way of working, and that's not something that you can implement from one day to another. So really, for this we help you to get ready for the marathon. We can help by creating awareness and providing trainings. We can help by establishing company-specific objectives. We can help with reviewing data processes and IT tools. For example, what do you do currently with your SPCs? Do you create them manually? Can we extract the data? So also with this tool that we did the demo, we can extract the data. And we also provide continuous updates of the developments of IDMP. So we give, after each meeting with IMA, we provide information to our clients about the IDMP developments. So for me, the take-home messages, it's the data extraction tool. It's really high accuracy. It saves time. It's quicker than manual work. It's easy to use. It's web-based interface. It's cost-effective solution. So data extraction is, I think, it's a need and an opportunity. XEVMPD is here to stay at least the next four years, maybe longer, depending on when ISO IDMP, and ISO IDMP will be implemented, so you can hide for it, but it will come, so you better get running in order to get ready. So this was the presentation. We have one more slide. Let me just show you. Okay, because in the last week we have been working on data extraction also for the adverse undesirable effects from the SPC. So also the tool is already able to extract data from the SPC and really classify it with the frequency. So I mean, here you see it in Spanish, but also in Dutch. So we can really see the undesirable effects per so how they are mentioned in the SPC, we can extract them, or the tool can extract them. I say we, but the tool can extract them, and they can really process them. So even in within 1 week, the guys from Taxonic Octopharm was really on the farm was really able to develop this within a single week, a nice feature, a nice functionality. So I'm sure that this is not the end. I mean, we are continuing to support, we are continuing to develop, and looking forward to have some discussion with you. So let me just check what are the questions. So we had some questions from people. Let me check if there's some. So there was one question: can we extract data when sections like undesirable effects in the format of a table? So I hope I just answered it. The answer is yes, we certainly can. We have implemented this last week in the demo. We didn't want to do this right now, but it works, so very happy. We had one other question. What other documents besides SMPC can the system process successfully? At this moment in time, we are focusing on the SPC, but from a technical point of view, there's no limitation for the patient information leaflet or module 3 documents. We're already having discussions. No, we have some clients that are interested in comparing SMPC with module 3 data and how we can do this. Jan, do you have any addition there? If Jan is still there. Okay. So we can. Jan is traveling, so he has problems to get online. So we are looking in how we can compare also the documentation from SMPC, from Module 3, do a cross comparison. We are also in contact with the authorities, how we can support them. Authorities will need to validate the data from the XEVMPD database, so they will need to compare the data in their database with the XEVMPD database, with the SMPC, with the Module 3, and ISO INMP will also change this whole process. So here we are looking in how we can do this. Then the last question that we have, so if you have any additional question, please feel free to put them into the screen. The system seems to be oriented towards IDMP iteration 1 only. What about other clinical particulars, contraindications, interactions? What are their respective codings? I mean, we are now focusing on iteration 1, but that's not the end. The full target is already to implement everything. So the full scope will be complete ISO IDMP implementation for all, if each and every field. There's another question. Considering the delay in IDMP timelines, do you think there are any chances for FDA or other countries to start the IDMP process prior to EMA? Well, that's a good question. EMA has been the main force behind ISO IDMP implementation. In the past, it was a project on ICH level, so Japan, US, and Europe. Japan clearly stated that for them, ISO IDMP would be too early. So Japan was out. I think that from US perspective, when we talk to the FDA colleagues, in FDA we have the SPL, and the SPL is already structured product labeling. So a lot of the data that we put in the SPL, FDA is already able to process this in a structured way. So when I talk to the FDA colleagues, their intention is really to implement, to upgrade the SPL with some additional data elements that are required for ISO IDMP, and then be ISO IDMP compliant. Sorry. So do I expect any other country to start IDMP implementation before EMA? I don't expect so, because if I see the challenges that we have with EMA, first of all, the ISO IDMP standard being available, then writing an implementation guide, getting software out there, I would highly doubt it that it would be possible. There was a question, how can we manage image files in this system? Can we please show some of them? Well, image files, it's quite difficult. Our recommendation, till now we have worked only with Word or PDF files. It is possible to work with scans, but you would need to OCR them before. The problem with OCR, is the reliability. But it's really something that we have to look into case-by-case situation. So there's also a question if the webinar will be available for downloading. We will certainly share the webinar. We will share a link to all the participants, and we can also share the presentation. So we have not received any additional question, but if anybody has a last question, we still have some time. So I will wait a few moments. Okay. If not, I would like to thank you all for attending this conference, this webinar. I'm very excited about this technology behind and the features that it has. I remember the XEVMPD projects that I did with my clients. We really got a lot of SPCs. We had to do manually extraction. It was not nice. It was painful. I think it was a painful experience for industry. And what we really want to do is for ISO IDMP to have a less painful implementation and really get the latest technology available and share this with our clients. So if you have any question, also feel free to contact us at idmp@asphalion.com. So it's IDMP from the ISO IDMP, idmp@asphalion.com, and to answer all your questions about ISO IDMP. Okay, thank you very much, and speak to you another time.